all who traveled to join these two beautiful souls in holy matrimony. I'm very blessed to be able to marry my son to the love of his life, Alexus. Fred and Alexus are a love story for the ages. A love story that will pass through the annals of time. A love story we can all strive to have in our lives. Brett and Alexus have written their own vows that they will be speaking now. Who starts? He does.
I can go first. I vow to provide for you, protect you, fight for you, live for you, and if necessary, die for you. I vow to share my days and my nights, my joys and my sorrows, my pleasures and pains with only you. I vow to raise you up and heal your ills, to kiss your wounds and enkindle your spirit. I vow to raise your young and make them strong. I vow to teach your children to respect, to love, and to do what is right. I vow to partner with you as we produce magical works in this life. I vow to be the wind in your sails, the fire in your furnace, the water that quenches your thirst, the earth beneath your feet, and the sky above your head. I vow to love you as one body and one flesh, Alexus, until the world breaks and eternity calls us home.
Oh God, mine are so much longer. That's okay. So you've got 4 pages here. Okay.
Do it.
Brett, you have made my life truly magical. A wizard is never late, nor is he early. He always arrives precisely when he needs to. You entered my life right when I needed you the most. Everything since then has fallen into place so well. You've done everything so perfectly and spoken all the right words to make me fall so hopelessly in love that I've never felt more like Princess Lexi than I do when I'm with you. We had met each other working at Domino's almost a year to the date before you decided to reach out to me. Cody, I know you had a part to play in that. Thank you so very much. Almost instantly, I knew I needed you. You made me feel like I was falling in love for the first time. So shy and gentle and playful, but we took things slow, but as easy as breathing. You also have made my life quite the adventure, starting off with our first date. You sang to me on our way to Little Saigon. I suggested we go the wrong way down a one-way street, completely on accident. I'm a little bit of a retard if y'all haven't figured that one out yet. Recalling how shy you were at dinner, it's completely night and day difference with how comfortable we are now. But it was so damn cute. I didn't mind doing what a Talkington does best. Going to the parking garage by Century 2, I was extremely nervous and relying and trusting in your directional skills, because obviously you can't trust mine. To get back home after taking me to see the Wichita Symphony, not knowing my musical history, you planned out the most perfect date for me. You have no idea how much that meant. Can I get a Kleenex?
Tissue someone?
Yeah. Yes, please. Can I get a Kleenex, Lexi? No. Never in my entire life have I ever had the confidence to make the first move. But something about you made me want to make you mine so bad that it hurt. So I grabbed your hand mid-show, and the look of shock on your face and the butterflies in our stomachs were absolutely priceless. Trusting your lead, we skipped back to the parking garage hand in hand. As the date came to a close, confidence overtook me again and I stole a kiss. That date made me feel like I belonged in a Disney princess movie. You made me feel like a princess saved by her knight in shining armor and living out the rest of our lives as Morticia and Gomez. I've never felt a love so intense or as passionate and undying as ours. I know how extremely lucky and grateful I am to have you.
so many search their entire lives trying to find a love like this. You are so very precious to me. I love you with all that I am or ever will be. I love you so much, in fact, that I vow to treat you with respect and admiration. I vow to be yours and only yours. I vow to keep that bottomless pit of a stomach of yours full with home-cooked food. I vow to take care of you to the best of my abilities. I vow to raise our kids side by side with you. I vow to try to better myself every day to be the best wife and mother to your children you could have ever asked for. And I vow to be your teammate, to listen, and to be a shoulder to lean on and to depend on. I vow to grow old with you, to die with you, and to live with you in your embrace forever. I'm ready, Freddy.
Wow.
Sorry, guys. I know that was long.
No, it was great.
Now, time Thank for the you. Rings.
Present the ring of power.
I'm sorry. I was more concentrated on the spider.
You're going to do it first? Okay. Alexis, repeat after me. Slide the ring on his finger. And say, Brett, I promise. To love, honor, and respect you.
To love, honor, and respect you.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
I'd like to have a prayer.
You don't have to continue to talk.
You don't have to continue to talk. What's the next one?
It's a prayer.
I'm leaving.
I'm leaving. Let's go, honey.
Okay.
He said we haven't kissed yet.
Prayer. Have a prayer. Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much for these two wonderful people that I've given birth to one of them and feel like I gave birth to the other. I just absolutely love them both, and I'm so blessed to be able to be a part of this wonderful union. I want to thank everybody for coming here. I thank you, Lord, for providing everybody with a safe journey. And I thank everybody who participated in this and sharing the love that these two share. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
With the power that is vested in me by the state of Missouri and Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you man and wife. Introducing Mr. and Mrs. Parrot. Woo!
All right, that's enough.